So it's March 4, 2019, meeting to session. We got invocation by Reverend Amy Fallon, Trinity Episcopal Church. Thank you for being here.
O Lord, our Governor, whose glory is in all the world, we commend this nation to your merciful care, that being guided by providence, we may dwell secure in peace. Grant to the elected members of this City Council of Kirksville, Missouri, the authority, wisdom, and strength to know and to do the right. Fill them with the love of truth and righteousness. Make them ever mindful of their calling to serve this people in your fear. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord, with whom you live and move and the Holy Spirit, world without end. Amen.
Amen. All right, pledge of the Girl Scouts of Eastern Missouri. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, ladies. Thank you.
And it's cookie season. You're all out at what, Walmart all weekend this weekend?
Yeah.
All right. This is Walmart.
All right, motion and second to approve minutes as corrected.
So moved.
Second.
All those approved? All those in favor?
Yeah.
Aye.
Any opposed? Order the agenda, Mayor.
So, Mayor and Council, as I mentioned prior to this, item number 7 is removed from the agenda and there will be no executive session.
All right, motion and second to approve the order of the agenda.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Information presentation, public hearing. Anyone that would like to come up and speak for up to 5 minutes pertaining to anything not on the agenda, please feel free to come to the podium and state your name and address, please.
To try to read this quickly because I'm probably at or over my 5 minutes.
Okay.
So don't start the timer yet. Is that microphone on, Belinda? Can you hear her?
Tap on.
Can you hear me?
You have to be
right into really it. Okay. Yeah. All right, Belinda, I apologize.
Okay, I'll try.
Just go ahead and start the timer.
Okay. Again, stop me if I go over my 5 minutes and I've got handouts here. I want to thank the city for providing citizens a chance to review the changes to the city codes last week. However, there was no link provided for online comments on the half sheets available at the meetings, nor was one included when the links to each day's subject matter was posted on the city site. Should online suggestions be sent to the publicinfo@kirksvillecity.com? I'm sure most of you know that I'm upset by the lack of any change regarding hoofed animals on residential property. I don't see on the code's proposals from last week that there is any change to the wording in section 515, limitation of animals, or section 2550, accessory use, private stables. But you added a new line in section 2599, F10, special uses, keeping of horses or ponies on a lot 1 acre or larger. What is the intention? As I've said before, I think the only hoofed animals currently on residential property are next door to us, and maybe some goats on West LaHart. I'm not sure that they are still there or that any ag land is involved. There are other horses in town, but as far as I can tell, there's agricultural assessment on those lots. So contrary to what some of the council thinks, evidently most residents with acreage in town have the good common sense and consideration not to move horses onto residential property and to ruin a neighborhood with the blight, smell, and filth. Excuse me. Why is the city so resistant to changing this code? A push is being made to beautify the city, and this certainly isn't helping. If a town as small as Bevere can have an ordinance prohibiting hoofed animals, then why shouldn't a city of our size? One simple line stating no hoofed animals shall be allowed on any residential property would be sufficient. along with striking agricultural out of R1 zoning or limiting that to truck gardens. Instead of allowing that by simply moving an animal onto a residential property, it is converted to ag standards. The people that currently have the animals would, of course, be grandfathered in. And I do have a handout of how that could be done. I think the residents should know that the current city codes allow anyone with at least 20,000 square feet of land in 30-foot lot lines and back 100 feet from the front can put up an electric fence strand, put one horse, pony, mule, or cow on the lot, and then not have to mow that lot or keep it up to residential standards, with the exception of mowing the perimeter. Excuse me. There is no mention of goats, sheep, or pigs in the code, so I guess you can do anything you want to with them. I won't go into how they calculate the number of animals allowed, but next door to us, they allow 8 horses on a lot barely over an acre. The ASPCA suggests 1.5 to 2 acres of ground per horse, and the MU Extension Service suggests 2 to 4 acres. I pointed this out to the city manager almost 3 years ago, then again to the Senate Council on June 12, 2017, but no changes have been made. I'm sorry. Moving my voice. I have 2 glaring examples of how little attention is paid to these animals. On September 21st, 2017, one of the ponies got outside the required fencing area and was trapped. It couldn't get back to water. I turned in a citizen request, but didn't hear back, so submitted another request. Nothing again, so on Monday the 25th, I called to get the Coast Department to come out and meet me. The owners had no idea this pony was trapped for 4 very hot days. Code simply drove around the east side of the property and decided nothing was wrong, instead of contacting me. 2 weeks ago, there was a dead horse on the property for a day. And I'm pretty sure the owners didn't notice that until codes came out. We still don't know the actual disposition of that horse. I also want to point out that defining a horse as an agricultural endeavor in this day and age is ridiculous unless you're Amish. I haven't seen a horse plow field in my lifetime, and most farmers use 4-wheelers these days to check on their livestock. The public should know that there was a horse on lot 54 by 108, less than a block off Baltimore, that was probably hidden by trees and shrubs until the fall leaves fell. That's in no way met the acreage requirement. It took citizen complaints to get that horse removed and also deal with the unlicensed vehicles on that property. Doesn't the city codes department or the police department notice these things? I don't want another resident of this city to have to endure what we have. The continued disregard for ordinances without much action to change. The responses I received by the former Coast Director and who exacerbated the situation. Then how the police treated me when the neighbor called to say I was harassing her and that she feared for her life when I simply did what the Coast Director told me to do, try to talk to her. The former Coast Director had told her to call the police if I ever harassed her. I was simply trying to talk to her about fencing. Excuse me. The municipal judge court tried to solve the problem by assessing a fine and telling them they'd be fined for every offense, but that has never happened. Both owners of the property were not issued the summons by the codes department as required by the codes. I think that's 1.11. Okay. I still have a couple, but I've got handouts.
Okay.
And I'm glad to share that with anybody that would like them.
Anyone else like to come up to speak?
I'm Donald Smith, number 7 Chelsea Drive, Kirksville, Missouri.
Okay, Donald, can you write your name on that book there for us, please? We have a new clerk tonight. We're trying to help her out a little bit.
To know how come Illinois wasn't contracted out instead of making people work under the street for take a whole year and don't fix the streets in Kirksville. I think it's ridiculous. We have cracks all over Eastern Village Trailer Court, and if they tear up my vehicle, you're responsible for the streets. You should be responsible for the repairs on any vehicle. I mean, you ain't taking care of none of them. But you can index more land in, and you don't even take care of what you got. That's poor responsibility. Got you.
Anyone else? Okay. Any unfinished business?
Well, we still have a public hearing.
Oops, I jumped over that. Sorry. All right. We're going to open the public hearing. West Parlor Street vacation request. Glenn?
Thank you, Mayor, members of the council. We've had a couple of citizens come forward with a vacation request on one of the streets that we've not, that's been vacated for quite a while, and it's not been used. Basically, if on our street map, the street in itself is kind of locked in there between the railroad and Main Street, and it really does not provide any connectivity within the city, and it's not an important street like a collector or an arterial. Therefore, the property owners on themselves have maintained the property as well. They've gone in there, mowed the right-of-way and put gravel on the driveway and so forth, and they like to continue to do that. And in doing so, they'd like to improve their properties adjacent to that. Both Larry Gibson is one of the property owners, and Joe Treese is another property owner. Both have come forward with a vacation request on the property. So at this time, if you have any questions.
Any questions?
I don't have any questions, no.
Public commentary? Okay. Close. Okay. Nemo Heart Health check presentation. I skipped over that too, I apologize. They told me I'm getting hurt and I didn't do anything.
Kelly Hunsikert is here with Nemo Heart Health.
Okay.
Kelly, is there anybody else?
Dr. Rickleman's here.
Okay.
I'm a tall guy.
You know, it's terrible. I almost said, you know, I really didn't see you in the corner there.
He blends in.
I blend in.
If you can come forward, please. The council was given your report for this past year. So I don't know if you had any questions.
On behalf of the city.
Do you want to shake his hand?
No, sure, I guess we can do it.
Okay.
If you guys just want to get in line, we can all do it. Good? Here you are.
Thanks, sir.
I'll give you the check. How's that?
He's
going to
give it to me in about
5 seconds.
All right,
exactly. That's the way it works at my house, too.
That'd be nice if I want more eating now. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. All right. Now we'll try to get back on track. I apologize. Any unfinished business?
I'm curious, no.
All right. Action presentation. City clerk reading of bill number 9.
An ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, approving the vacation of street public right-of-way on West Quarter Street from Main Street to the abandoned Norfolk Western Railroad right-of-way.
Right. Motion and second to approve on first reading.
So moved.
Second.
Thank you, Mayor. As part of our responsibility, we take a look at the property as far as the use of this right-of-way, and what I have found, I've contacted the utility companies, the adjacent that are in the area, you know, the water, the sewer, as well as our own, and talked to our supervisor and public works department about the property. And we have found no use as far as easements in that right of way as well. So I've kind of indicated in my report then that they acknowledge that they had no future use of this property as well. And part of that also includes the fire department and the police also acknowledge that for emergency vehicles as well, they have other routes that this really wouldn't be of any impact to their services.
Okay.
As far as the cost of the recording fees and the public hearing, that would be borne by the property owner.
Okay.
Other than that, there would be no fiscal impact to our budget.
Any council discussion?
This is the first vacation thing I've been a part of since I was on the council. I was really pleased to see the amount of due diligence that goes into checking with all the different utilities and our own city services to make sure that it's not going to impact anything negatively. So I was really pleased to see that. Thanks for the work on that one.
You're welcome.
Citizens' questions or input? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you.
All right. Motion and second to approve on second reading.
City clerk reading.
Sorry. City clerk reading.
An ordinance of the city of Kirksville, Missouri, approving the vacation of street public right-of-way on West Porter Street from Main Street to the abandoned Norfolk Western Railroad right-of-way.
All right. Motion and second to approve on second reading.
So moved.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
All right. City clerk reading of bill number 10.
An ordinance of the city of Kirksville, Missouri, authorizing the execution of an agreement between the city of Kirksville, Missouri Main Street Connection Incorporated, MMSC, and the Kirksville Downtown Improvement Committee Incorporated, KDIC, for participation in a Rural Community Development Initiative grant sponsored by USDA Rural Development.
Okay, motion and second to approve on first reading.
So moved. I'll second that.
Okay. Sarah?
Good evening. In 2018, the KDIC applied with the support of the city, local businesses, and citizens for Missouri Main Street Affiliate Grant. They were awarded this grant, which gives them a two-year grant for services through the Missouri Main Street Initiative. This is 60-40, so we did raise the funds for the KDIC did raise the funds to do that, and the city supported that. In June of 2018, the KDIC was approached by Missouri Main Street asking if they would like to participate in this My Community Matters Initiative, as they're calling it now. It was a form saying, yes, we'd like to. By doing that, they are now going to get an additional $35,000 to $50,000 in services through Missouri Main Street because they did receive the funding through USDA to do so. So that gives them approximately $60,000 to $75,000 of services through these two programs. The requirements are very similar to what they required through the Main Street Affiliate Grant Program. So they do have to attend some off-site trainings as well as some on-site trainings. The commitment the city specifically has to make is that a city representative has to attend in either 2019 and or 2020 the Main Street Summit in Branson. That would require travel, lodging, and time away from work for the employee to attend that conference. But most of those, they have quarterly reports, economic data collection, and minutes, things like that, that they are already doing through the affiliate grant program. And one of the requirements is the city has to sign off in order for them to participate in that. The KDIC did approve it at their February meeting and has signed off on it. So now they're bringing it to the council to see about approval. I apologize, I keep saying we. I'm also on their board. I play dual roles. I'm the city's representative for KDIC. So.
Any council discussion or questions?
No.
Citizens' questions or input? All those in favor?
Aye.
City clerk second reading.
An ordinance of the city of Kirksville, Missouri, authorizing the execution of an agreement between the city of Kirksville, Missouri Main Street Connection Incorporated, MMCSC, and the Kirksville Downtown Improvement Committee Incorporated, KDIC, for participation in the Rural Community Development Initiative grant sponsored by USDA Rural Development.
All right, motion and second to approve on the second reading.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
City clerk reading of a resolution.
A resolution authorizing amendment 2 to the water tower agreement from Benson and Associates for bidding and construction inspection services.
Motion and second to approve.
So moved.
Second.
Lynn.
Thank you, Mayor, members of the council. A little background on the project. You're well aware of it, the water tower improvement that we had planned for back in 2016. We did hire Benton Associates to begin the project through a study phase, and through that study phase we determined the location, and based on the location we went ahead with their design services. And then the follow-up of that, there's always the construction portion of the engineering part of the project. We did not include that at the beginning for the fact that we may be doing it ourselves, but due to the recent grants that we received through CDBG and the TAP grant, plus the additional street workload that we'll be doing this year, that we just did not have enough manpower at this point to be able to do that. We've got to shift our priorities, so to speak, on the work that we do have, and rather than take on more, we would like to keep Benton Associates engaged in the project, since they are the designers. They do have the experience and they do have the personnel to actually inspect the tower itself as it's being built, so I think they would provide a much better service for us to do that, and because they do have the background, the history in the company to be able to build these towers, and there's a lot of foundation work involved with this. So at this point, we would like to ask for the extension of their contract to incorporate the inspection and construction services.
Okay. Any questions or council discussion?
Well, I'm just kind of curious on what the financial breakdown is with that. Are we looking mostly on the inspection side of it, or where does most of the funds spent on that?
On their fee.
Mm-hmm.
Are you talking about between the design and the inspection, or
for the what we're looking at here, the amendment?
On the amendment.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right, on the amendment, the contract's going to take about over a year to do, and it's not going to be just 40 hours a week. It's going to be as they need to have the inspection services provided. We're still going to oversee the consultant as well as the contractor and as far as payments and things like that. That's still going to be handled through our group, but basically the services would be through their construction people. And any the testing services, there's going to be quite a bit of concrete going on, you know, with the foundation work and the structure itself, and then also there are also the other part of this is then the water line is going to be installed to the water main from Osteopathy on over. That'll be another contract in itself, but both of them together, their estimated fee was $110,000 back 2 years ago, and they stayed with that same price.
Okay.
But the lion's share is for the inspection, not
right.
The testing.
Correct.
Any more council discussion? Citizens' questions or input? All those in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mark,
City Clerk reading of a resolution.
A resolution authorizing amendment number 2 to the water tower agreement from Benton and Associates for bidding and construction inspection services.
Crystal.
A resolution authorizing the purchase of a Caterpillar DG-125-2 natural gas generator and switchgear from Altifer Power Systems and authorizing the work to complete the installation of the generator.
Motion to second.
So moved.
Second. Mr.
Blue. That one's difficult to read if you don't know what it is, isn't it? Mr. Mayor and Council, we're replacing a generator in City Hall. We did the one at Public Works last year. It was over 4 years old. This one's over 30 years old, and no time for replacement. That puts us in good shape with our generators throughout the city. We're also going something we realize is that these generators that are not mobile, that sit with diesel fuel on them all the time, have problems. So we're going with natural gas on that. Another thing we did too is but the City Hall folks, Codes and Engineering, went through and determined what it takes to power the whole building, because this generator only powers 911. This shuts down. So we're buying a generator big enough to power all the essential pieces of City Hall so that finance can keep going and things keep going with the power outage. It shows the generator cost at $58,000 with the switchgear. Switchgear is a main piece of the operation. That doesn't cover. We got to get a crane, we got to have installation, we got to get the gas put in. So we're not sure where we'll come out underneath the 100,000, but we will come in under 100,000. So we're in the middle of that now, but now we got to get the generator here, and we've got to pour a pad for it. There's a lot of small pieces to make it all happen. So based on your question approves so we can purchase the generator and get going on this project.
Council discussion or questions?
Switch gear going inside City Hall or outside?
Switch gear go outside. That's the gear, so when electricity goes off, it automatically switches over.
Gotcha.
We realized that Public Works, that's a pretty complex piece of the machinery. Sure. When they put that in there, it takes a real electrician to make that happen. So that's where the switch gear will go. I guess, am I right, Bill? Hey, Bill's here. He did all the heavy lifting.
There we go.
All right, any other questions?
No.
Citizens' questions or input? All those in favor?
Aye.
All right, City Clerk reading of a resolution.
A resolution authorizing the purchase of a 2019 Ford Ranger four-wheel drive pickup from Luck Green Ford.
All right. Motion and second to approve.
So moved.
Second.
So this is a replacement. We're replacing an older vehicle. Just to let you know, this vehicle that we're replacing was actually on the list 2 years ago, but because of the program we came up with to keep things longer, the vehicle's being replaced is just under 200,000 miles. We've kept it that long and kept it running that long. It's just a normal replacement of a vehicle that we need to, it's time to go because we're starting to see mechanical issues with it. And pending your questions, request you approve.
Okay.
Oh, we did go out local bid too. Everybody got a chance to bid on it. So we do local bids on, if everyone locally can bid on this, we take it out for a local bid all the time. So we
well, bravo that. On using it up and wearing it out. That's a good policy.
That's part of it.
Well, it's what we're doing. We're that. Yeah.
Appreciate that. Any other council discussion?
No.
Uh-huh. Citizens' questions or input? All those in favor?
Aye.
All right. City Clerk reading of a resolution.
A resolution authorizing the purchase of a Sutphin Monarch Custom Pumper Fire Apparatus from Sutphin Corporation, taking delivery in 11 to 13 months, and authorizing the city manager and staff to execute all the necessary documents.
Motion and second to approve.
So moved.
Second.
So my name's at the top, but I want to turn it over to Bill. Bill's okay. Did all the work on this and did all the negotiations with the fire and with the companies and all that, so I'm going to let him give this presentation.
Thanks,
Glenn. Mayor, Council, we've talked about this truck prior to this. Basically, it's the Sutphin that I had recommended we purchase. Sutphin, that way we'll have try to keep everything the same rather than going to a different brand for every truck. It just makes things a lot easier at the repair end. So it's going to be a rescue pumper. I've got a few pictures of similar of what it would look like if anybody cares to see them.
Oh, I'm curious. Yes. Okay. I like the drawings, but I'll take a look at the pictures too. Thank okay. you.
They have the pictures, just not the pretty color.
It's not the exact right color, but that's basically what the truck will look like. Basically we were able to do this without putting a down payment down. We just basically have to sign a contract and we can go ahead and get it ordered. That's the important thing right now because there's a 12-month roughly build time. So the sooner we can get this ordered, the sooner we can, you know, get in line. And then once we get that done, once we'll go to a pre-build meeting and there'll be some detail worked out on the truck then. There'll be probably some few things changed around. Once we get to talk to the engineers at the company, they'll make some recommendations to maybe change certain things to make it more usable, which the money's still going to be the same. It's just there'll be some details worked out once we're at the pre-build meeting.
Okay. And which truck is this replacing?
It'll be replacing 501, which is a 1997
okay.
Pierce, and it's starting to get pretty tired.
Yeah. Council discussion or questions?
This is a custom piece to just for everybody. What are some things that we're specifically looking at that we're going to be able to get out of this particular apparatus?
It's kind of a custom, but it's called a program truck, so it's a body that they use a lot of, so they're pre-built, mm-hmm. and which makes it a little bit quicker to build rather and a little bit cheaper rather than building a complete custom.
Gotcha.
But it'll basically just be it'll take the place of 504, which is also a rescue pumper. 504 was that truck that it never seemed to quite perform like it should. It'll make a really good reserve truck, but it just seems like it's always got some issue cropping up when it's used daily. And so that's going to take basically the place of it in the long run once we get the truck.
And John Cook is in the audience, Deputy Chief, if you have questions about the truck from an operational standpoint.
Anything for Mr. Cook?
I think I'm good.
Okay. Any Citizens' questions or input? All those in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, sir. Any comments, anyone?
It's been brought up tonight about the condition of city streets, and I'll just remind folks that after a tough winter, we're going to have some potholes and things around, but Glenn and his crew are more than happy to go out and take a look at those. If people will call in requests or use our online system or pop down to City Hall, I know we've talked with a lot of folks already who've been getting some really great results with that to make sure that we're working with that. City crew work on streets. The asphalt plant and everything attached to that allows us to do more miles of city streets than we've ever done before. So I think it's important to continue to point that out, that the system that we've got in place is allowing us to tackle roads better than we've ever had a chance to before, and I'm pretty proud of that. So proud of the staff for working on that too.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Anyone else? All right. Motion and second to adjourn.
So moved.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Adjourn. Thank you all for coming.